Good morning all. This chapter deals with the textile science. This is considering the or discussing about the textiles and clothing. Then we can go through the word textile. The term textile is originally a Latin word meaning woven or applied to all the woven fabrics in the ancient times, but nowadays it generally applied to all type of textile fabrics. Even it is not from the fibers. It may be from the leather or metal or anything else. Any materials that is constructed to a textile is a clothing is known as the textile. Then what do you mean by clothing? Clothing is the items worn on the body. Clothing is typically made of fabrics or textiles, but any materials also included in that. And at the same time, this is constructed to worn on our body, and the things that is related to the clothing is also comes under clothing. Sorry, textiles is comes under clothing. Neckties, handbands, etc. are included in this. All type of constructed materials worn by a human being is considered as clothing. Textile is the fabric material only. It's a woven or knitted or bonded fabrics, whatever may be, is a textile. But the clothing is anything that is worn by an individual is known as a clothing. That is the difference between textiles and clothing. Both these are detailed in our session very minutely. Only the basic of all these are considered and studied in this portion. So just we are moving to the textile science. Textile science is the study of the process of which cloth is produced. It is a program that focuses on the properties and processing of fibers, yarns, whole fabrics, dyes and finishes, both natural and synthetic. It includes the study of chemical and physical properties of textile materials, end-use analysis, both textile and fashion application, interior furnishing application and industrial application. All these are considered textile science. So textile science is basically dealing with all the uses and all the processing of fiber to fabric. Then what is fiber? Fiber is the basic visible unit. It is the fundamental unit of any fabrics. Here we are in the textile sense, we are just only considering about the fibers to fabric construction and its processing only. So we are detailing about the fiber and its different properties and the construction methods, etc. We are not considering about the accessories or the other materials that is used as clothing. We are just considering the textiles only. So this is the fibers. Fibers are the basic visible unit of any fabrication or any textile cloth. So some are short, some are very long fibers. Example, you know, silk is very long fiber, and then cotton is very short fiber. This may be high or low tensile strength, that is elasticity. Then maybe transparent, opaque or colored or colorless. It is not of the fabric. Every fabrics are colorful, but it is dyed to be colorful. But in the original form, the fibers are most probably opaque or transparent. Some are colored or colorless. Color means off-white or cream color. Then fibers usually group and twisted together into a continuous strand called yarns. Always these fibers not used in the fabrics as such. They are twisted together to long fibers. That is known as the yarns. These yarns are used for the construction of fabrics. Then the classification of fiber based on the length. Based on the length, fibers are classified into filament fiber and the staple fiber. From the diagram itself, you can define the fiber. Filament fibers are the long fibers and staple fibers are the short fibers. That is, staple fibers can be in 1 to 3 inches in length, but the filament fibers are measured in meters or yards. Then the classification of fibers based on the source from where it is processed. So that is the source of the fiber. Based on the source, the fibers are classified into natural fibers and the man-made fibers. That is the basic classification. Natural fibers are the fibers that we obtained from the nature itself. It's a natural fiber. Then the man-made fibers are the fibers that we are processed or constructed from the chemicals. Chemicals are converted to fibers. It is in the it is converted to molten stage, or the chemicals are dissolved in a solution. Then these solutions are passed through the spinnery to form the fibers. So these are the man-made fibers. It is purely chemical, and there is also fibers that are produced by regenerating the cellulose. So this that is also a man-made fiber, because the waste products of cellulose is made into a solution, and these solutions are passed through the spinneret to form the fiber. That is, rayon is an example. So that is also a man-made fiber. So there are two types of fibers: natural and man-made fibers. Then the natural fibers are again classified into three: vegetable fibers, animal fibers, and the minerals. Vegetable fibers, as the name indicates, it is from the vegetable sources. Cotton, linen, hemp, etc. are the vegetable fibers. Then the animal fibers is origin from the animals. Wool and silk are the examples. Mineral fibers are from the rocks. The basic constituents is mineral. They are asbestos, glass, and metal. Then the vegetable fibers are basically from vegetables. So it is a undigested part. Polysaccharides is the cellulose, and the hemicellulose forms the fiber. So the basic constituent or major constituent on the vegetable fiber is cellulose. Then the animal fibers, the animal foods are, you know, the animal foods are rich in protein. As such, the animal fibers are also rich in protein. They are the main constituent of animal fiber is protein. So this is they are known as the animal fibers or the protein fibers. Then the third one is the mineral fibers. This is obtained from the rocks and other mineral materials. These are rich in minerals. The main constituent is mineral. Examples are the asbestos, glass, metal, etc. Then the four man-made fibers is classified into regenerated fibers and the synthetic fibers. Regenerated fibers are generated from a basic natural material. So that is regenerated. Again, generated, again, regenerated. So they are the fibers that are generated from a basic natural material, which is dissolved in a chemical substance to form a solution, and these solutions are passed to the spinneret to form the fiber. Example is rayon and acetate are the example. Then synthetic fibers are purely chemical fibers. There is no natural content in it. They are from the chemical substance dissolved and to form a solution. It may be a gel, this may be a emulsion, anything, but it is in a liquid form. These liquids are passed through the spinneret to form the fibers, but the constituent are chemicals, so the properties also vary based on the chemicals used in the manufacturing. So these are the synthetic fibers. Example, nylon, polyester are the examples of man-made fibers, man-made synthetic fibers. Then next is the properties of fibers. There are physical properties, chemical properties, and biological properties. We are discussing the properties of each fiber separately in the following chapters. So just this is an introduction for the properties. We are going to study about each and every fiber. So this is the basic about this. First is the physical properties. Physical properties, considering the visual properties we are observing in a fiber, that is a microscopic appearance, length, composition, strength, moisture, absorbency, shrinkage, resiliency, heat conductivity, etc. Then the chemical properties is the action with acids, alkalis, bleaches, dyes, etc. That is their chemical reaction with the chemical substance. Then the biological properties are the its reaction to the biological agents such as moth, insects, weevil, beetle, etc. So these are the three headings under which we are going to consider the properties of fiber as in the next portions. Then length, as we discussed earlier, it is of two types: filaments fibers and the staple fibers. Staple fibers are short in length. That is 3 by 4 to 18 inches length is the small fibers. These are the staple fibers. Filaments fibers are the long fibers. It is a long fibers of continuous length measurable in yards or meters. So, quarter 3/4 to 1.8 inches is length is considered as the staple fibers. More than that, that is up to yards or meters, it can be measured. That is known as the filament fibers. Then the strength. Strength is determined by the load bearing capacity. The strength also determines the ability to resist stress while in the weaving process or the bonding process. The strength is determined based on that the tension is given to the fiber. Strength may also be measured by how much force it takes to rip the fabric or tear the fabric or rupture the fabric. Basic strength. For the fibers, it is pulled. Some weight is hanged on the fiber, and at which weight it breaks is the strength is determining factor. And strength is calculated on the weight, how much weight it can load. That is the strength of the fiber. The time of rupture called the tenacity. The particular point at which the fiber breaks is this tenacity. Tenacity of a worked fiber may be different from the tenacity of that of the warp fiber, and both the warp and weft fiber have the tenacity different from the wet and dry condition. Cotton have cotton increases its strength when it is wet, but silk loses its strength when it is wet. So there are differences from fiber to fiber, the tenacity and the strength. Next is the flexibility. These are the terms we are commonly going to use in the while studying the properties of fiber. So we are discussing it here. Then the flexibility. Flexibility means how pliable is it. It determines the drapability of the fabric. So how much it is flexible is determined by the flexibility. Then only it can be wrapped around another. That is the difference between the cotton material and the nylon material. Cotton is not as drapable as nylon or polyester material, or silk is also highly drapable. So that is the difference in the flexibility. Then a flexible fiber can be made into a highly drapable fabric, and the drapability is related to the flexibility of the fiber. As you can find it very easily, or you can compare it with the cotton fiber, cotton fabric and the silk fabric. Cotton fabric is stiff, but the silk fabric is so flexible, so it is drapable. Then we want these two fabrics, there are visible difference, so that is a flexibility. Then cohesiveness is not for the customer application, but it is for the adherence of the fibers that makes it suitable for different types of fabric constructions. Cohesiveness is the sticking property of fibers. This sticking property based on the structure of the fiber. For cotton, it is a twisted fiber, but for wool, it has scales on the surface, but silk doesn't have a scale or a twist, it is a rod shaped. So when comparing these three fibers, wool has the highest cohesiveness, next cotton, then there is no cohesiveness between the fibers in the silk. So that is why wool is used to prepare the felted fabrics. Is the property used in based on the cohesiveness of the fiber. It will be discussed detailed in the coming sessions. So it is a cohesiveness or adherence of the fibers together that helps to twist the fiber or to make it a bonded fabric. Then uniformity. Uniformity produces a uniform fabric that is understood by everyone. So uniformity has a major role in formation of a uniform or a clean and clear fabric. So uniformity is important. Man-made fibers are more uniform than the natural fibers. It provides a uniform appearance to the fabric. Then the microscopic view. Microscopic view, under the microscope, these fibers have varying configurations. There are cross-sectional and the longitudinal section of the structure of the fibers that can be found under the microscope. Color. The natural fibers are white to nearly black or dirty white color is the variations. But in the man-made fibers, they are pure white. they are bleached to form a pure white, then it is dyed. The texture is the nature of the fiber or the fabric surface. It is identified by the visual feel. Fabrics may have smooth or rough structure. Natural fibers tend to give a fabric more texture than man-made fibers because of their inherent variations. Cotton fibers are rough, but the silk fabric is lustrous or the smooth texture. Luster is the reflection of light from the fabric surfaces. Cotton is not lustrous, but the silk is lustrous. That you can determine what is luster means. It reflects the greater amount, silk reflects greater amount of light, so it is more lustrous than the cotton fabric. Most of the man-made fibers are lustrous. If it is not at all lustrous, we can make it lustrous by certain finishing processes. Then moisture absorbency is the moisture absorbency is the ability to absorb the moisture. Fibers such as cotton has the highest moisture absorbency. Wool also absorbs more moisture. Moisture retention is higher in wool, so they are hard to dry. But compared to cotton, cotton has the lowest dry property, or the retention of moisture is high in cotton compared to the silk. And the moisture absorbance is very low in all the man-made fibers. So it is easy to dry and wash and keep it well. Then resiliency is the ability fiber to return to its normal shape when it is dry. So there is a wrinkling property of the cotton that doesn't make the resilient. So cotton has the lowest resiliency, but wool and silk also is resilient fiber, because they can come back to the normal position when it is dry. Then flammability is the property to catch fire. Flammable fibers, flame resistant fibers, and the fireproof fibers are rare. Flammable fibers, most of the cellulosic fibers are flammable fibers. They catch fire easily. You can see it, the cotton catches fire easily, but the silk and wool take time to catch fire. Then common properties of a cellulose fibers. They have low resiliency, high water absorbency, good conductor of heat, resistant strong alkalis, susceptible to strong mineral and organic acids, resistance to moth. You are going to study about the linen and the cotton fibers, so it is helpful to you. These are the general properties of all cellulosic fibers or the vegetable fibers. Then these are the common properties of the protein or the animal fibers. You are going to study silk and wool under this category. The common properties are weak strength. If wet, in the wet condition, it weakens the strength. But cellulosic fibers increases the strength when it is wet. High resiliency, cotton fibers are raw resilient. Bad conductor of electricity. Cottons are good conductor of cellulosic fibers are good conductor of electricity, susceptible to strong acids, resistance to dilute mineral acids, susceptible to oxidizing agents, do not support AC combustion, it doesn't take fire easily. Then properties of mineral fibers, it is not meant for you, but just a general information giving to you. It is fireproof, resistant to acid, and highest pliability. Then common properties of man-made fibers. This is a nutshell. That is what we are going to study is an introduction to all. So just by heart it. Then if we further move on to each properties of each fiber, it will be easy for you to study well. Common properties of man-made fibers: high strength, resistant to abrasions. Abrasions is friction. Strong when wet. High resiliency, elasticity, and elongation. Low moisture absorption. Low affinity for dyes, dye absorption property is low because of low moisture absorption. Then low heat resistance, high heat setting, high resistance to moths, mildews and insects. Then fiber identification, how we can identify a particular fiber. There are a lot of tests for the fiber identification. The tests followed are burning test, microscopic test, solubility test, optical test, density test, etc. Here we are discussing only about the basic tests, tests like visual test, microscopic test, and the burning test. Okay, next, visual inspection. How can inspect the fibers visually? The visual inspection of fabric for appearance and hand feel is always the first step in the fiber identification. Feeling test is subjective test. This requires skill. Skill perception is secured only after handling many different types of fabrics. So you have to identify here onwards. You have to identify each and every fabrics passing through your hands so that you will be skillful. Then this is a practical for your plus two practical exams. Look for the following. When we are inspecting, we have to look for the following things: length of the fiber, luster or lack of luster, and texture, how it feels to the hand. The visual inspection is carried by the following method: grasp the edge of the cloth between the thumb and the index finger, then rub on the top, rub the thumb and the forefinger across the cloth lengthwise, and then circle. Then find the pliability, elasticity, warmth, softness and smoothness can be felt. The vegetable fibers are usually cooler to touch than the animal fibers or the synthetic fibers. A 100% cotton fiber without a finish is lifeless. Linen is cool and pliable. Silk is very soft and lustrous. Wool is warm and resilient. However, it is very difficult to identify each fiber, especially the synthesis by mere touch, because the type of yarn used, the finish and the construction can often change the feel of the fabric. Because we can make the cotton into a mercerized cotton, or we can convert it to a very silky we can give silky finish to cotton fabrics through certain processing methods. So it is the feel may not be correct, because if the fabric is passed through the finishing process. So it is a primary detection that what will be the fabric. As we see, it is lustrous. It may not be silk, because cotton can be made to lustrous by mercerization process. So it is a primary information. Just the length of the fiber can be determined by unraveling one fiber from the fabric. Then the yarn is we are getting the yarn. The yarn is untwisted from between the forefinger and the thumb, and the small fiber can be taken from the yarn, and by seeing the length of the fiber, we can determine it is a man-made fiber or a natural fiber. Then the microscopic test. In the microscopic test, we can identify it easily. Especially natural fibers can be differentiated through the microscopic test. Then the correct structure can be observed through the microscope. For this, it is mounted in a wash glass by a drop of water is added, and the fiber, the unraveled fiber, not the yarn. The yarn is unraveled and the fiber is taken from the yarn, and that fiber is mounted in the wash glass and observed under the microscope to see the structure of the fiber. This is the structure of the fiber. This is a comparison between the cotton and the silk. In the cotton, it is a flat structure, ribbon like twisted structure, no crimp, no central lumen or no luster is found in the fiber. This is the structure of the cotton fiber. Below is the structure of the silk fiber. It is a rod like structure, circular, highly lustrous, gum present in the surface. The surface, the dark colored outline is the gum portion. There are not even, it is uneven, because due to the presence of gum on the surface, and the darkened line is the presence of gum. So in the silk fibers, there is gum portions. So the edges may not be fine. There is no crimp and highly lustrous, circular and rod shaped. In the structure, you can identify it. The silk is rod shaped, but it is flat for the cotton, and it is a twisted structure. Then the wool, it's a rough surface, crimp very evident, that is the scales on the surface, and then more or less circular, luster lacks luster because of the presence of scales. So it is a rod shaped, but it is a rough surface, scales are present in it, and there is no luster over it. That is the structure of the wool. Below is the nylon structure. Most of the man-made fibers are rod shaped. Hardly we can differentiate between the structures. Nylon, round rod-like structure, smooth surface, translucent, high luster and no crimp on the surface. This is a cross-sectional view. Cotton has the cross-sectional view like this. Length is 3 by 4 to 2 inches. Flax, wool and the silk, the structures, the cross-sectional structure is there. This is the longitudinal section and this is the cross section. Nylon, acetate, rayon and dacron. You can see from see it, this nylon, rayon and dacron are almost circular in shape. There is no difference. The silk is also round in structure, but there are scales and wood. Flask also have the structural difference, but the silk, nylon, rayon and dacron are all acetate also is all are rod shaped. The difference is very minute. This is the picture given in your textbook. Cotton, flat fiber, ribbon like, twisted, no crimp, no central lumen. There is a central lumen and no luster is found. Then linen, shiny surface, flat and translucent. Silk, rod like structure, circular, highly lustrous, gum present on the surface, no crimp. You have to buy hurt all the structures because it is for mean for the practical also. Wool, rough surface, crimp is very evident, scales present, more or less circular, lack of lustre. Nylon, round rod like structure, smooth surface, translucent, highly lustrous, no crimp. Polyester, smooth and transparent, rod shaped. Acrylic microtest cannot be used to identify the acrylic fiber. So most of the man-made fiber, the microscopic structure is not a final decision. Then the burning test. From the burning test, we can identify most of the fibers. I can distinguish the fibers. Burning test is a simple method of identifying fibers. All that is needed is flame and the knowledge of burning properties. The burning test can be used to identify fibers by groups such as the cellulosic group or the synthetic group. Burning test is useful on those who have no other method of identification. It is also useful as a confirmatory test. Blends cannot be identified by burning test. The burning test does have a certain limitations because the burning fiber may be affected by the finish applied to the fiber. General direction for burning test. Reveal out the test several yarns from each side of the fabric to see if they have the same fiber content, because if it is a blended fabric, each fiber is different. So we have to randomly select different fibers from the different part of the fabric so that we can identify which are the type of fibers present in them. Hold the yarn horizontally with a pair of tweezers or tongues. Use tweezers or tongues for the fiber for the burning test, otherwise it will burn your fingers. Feed the fiber slowly into the edge of the flame and observe what happens. Repeat this several times. Notice the order. Now observe the ash and repeat the filling as warp and the crosswise and the longwise fiber yarns separately. This is a flame test. Cotton, large yellow flame, burns quickly, burning pepper smell, gray, feathery, smooth ash is formed. For rayon, it is also a large yellow flame and burns quickly. Is a burning pepper smell, same as gray, feathery, smooth ash, but maybe is of a dark color. Then wool, small, slow, flickering flame, burn slowly, burning hair smell, crushable, black ash, but the ash may be a larger size compared to the silk. Silk, small, slow, flickering flame, burn slowly, burning hair, crushable, black ash. Wool is distinguished from silk by the visual observation, and in the ash, most probably the wool forms a larger crushable ash, B-shaped ash, but silk forms a smaller B-shaped ash. Polyester burns slowly with melting or black smoke, but nylon for white smoke, slightly sweetish. Boiling celery is for the nylon. Hair black bead, both are hard, black bead is formed. But nylon, a round bead shaped but hard ash is formed. This is in your textbook. Cotton rushes towards the flame, catches fire and burns rapidly till the end. Burning pepper smell, grayish ash, retains shape very soft to touch, that it burns in the shape of the fabric itself. Linen does not shrink, burns quickly. Continuous burning shows an afterglow. After extinguishing, it shows a glow. Paper burning smell itself, light feathery gray ash is formed. Silk, approaching the flame, there is no reaction because it catches flame very slowly. Then catches fire, self-age. When removed from the flame, it burns out, that is self-extinguishing. The previous both are not self-extinguishing. They are non-self-extinguishing. They cannot be burnt out after removing from the fire. It continues to burn even if removing from the flame. But extinguishes after removing from the flame in the case of silk and wool. Then say both are not, you doesn't write the same as wool. You have to write burning hair or feather smell. Then the ashes are also black, curled up, ash, cringy to touch in the silk and wool, but we can differentiate by the size of the bead. Nylon shrinks from the flame, catch fire, melt and draws, that is the difference. It melts and draws, stops burning and melting when removed from the flame. It's the smell of burning celery, molten, solidified, hard residue. When we melt, it melts and drops to the down portions. So we have to be careful while burning the nylon fabric. Then the polyester shrinks from the flame, melts, catches the fire and burns with sooty flame. Stops burning and melting. Plastic burning smell, molten, solidified, hard residue. Black in color, then that appears in the fabric itself. But in the case of nylon, it drops into the floor. Acrylic shrinks from the flame, catches fire and burns rapidly. Continuous burning with a flame, sputtering and melted fiber dripping, fire crackers. Then burns like firecrackers. There are crackers sounds and cracking in the burning time. Molten solidified residue. Rayon, no reaction, catches fire and burns faster, burns rapidly till the end. It is non-self-extinguishing. Burning paper smell because it is cellulosic in origin. Black ash, soft to touch, very small amount of ash is formed compared to the cotton. Cotton, there are ash formed as much as material we burn, the same quantity of ash is formed. But in the case of rayon, there is no ash, no quantity wise, there is very little ash is formed after burning of rayon. Cellulose acetate burns freely, melts and becomes pours into black ash, continues to burn and melt, has an acid, harsh, sharp odor similar to hot vinegar, residue is hard, dark, solid, bitter. You have to study all these burning tests and microscopic structure in detail and by heart. It is a question, it is for practical as well as theory. For the practical, it bears marks, and is also as for the theory. So by heart all the portions completely. Any doubts, ask in the group. Thank you.